you're doing well, and now if you don't mind, we're gonna get to the news. According to the latest numbers, President Biden has visited New York City 11 times since taking office. That's nothing. Trump's been here 11 times in the last month. Gets one of those little sketches done every time he's here.
He's like, can I get one in roller skates?
During an event yesterday in Philadelphia, President Biden appeared to mistakenly refer to the Marine One presidential helicopter as, quote, Air Force Helicopter One. You know what? I don't even think that's a gaffe. I think once you get to a certain age, you don't care what stuff is called anymore. It's the same reason your dad calls Yellowstone Yellow Ranch. He doesn't care. He just gets as close as he can and then goes, you know what the hell I mean. The one with Beth Dutton. Oh, he remembers her name. Harvard University announced today that President Claudine Gay will stay in her post following criticism of her testimony at a congressional hearing on campus anti-Semitism. Because if anyone's been punished enough, it's someone in Massachusetts named President Gay. That was submitted by our resident masshole, Mike Scollins. Ukrainian President Zelensky met today with House Speaker Mike Johnson before going to the White House to speak with President Biden, because in America, it's customary to go ask dad when mom says no. According to a new report, former President Trump contacted. Why did you spell it the right way? According to a new report, former President Trump reached out to an employee of Mar-a-Lago who witnessed multiple incidents of his handling of classified documents and offered the worker legal representation and free tickets to an upcoming golf tournament. Man, only Trump is lazy enough to bribe a witness with stuff he just has lying around.
We gotta shut this guy up, send over some golf tickets, and let's see, Rudy? Should we?
Jury selection began yesterday in the Georgia election workers' defamation case against Rudy Giuliani. Where are you gonna find a jury of his peers? Arkham Asylum? New York City Mayor Eric Adams spoke today at a multi-faith gathering. The only faith not represented was faith in Eric Adams. According to a new poll, 1 in 5 registered voters said they would be open to supporting presidential hopeful Robert F. Kennedy Jr. And if Kennedy can just talk to some of those people, he could get it to 1 in 10. Math joke. According to the latest numbers from AAA, more than 115 million people will travel more than 50 miles from their homes during the holidays, unless a miracle happens and one of your kids get COVID. Oh, my God. I got good news. Netflix yesterday announced it will air the Netflix Slam, which is its first ever live tennis match, and not, as I thought, a less romantic version of Netflix and Chill. It's a very good one that you're not going to forget soon. According to new research, teenage girls are more likely to use Instagram than teenage boys. Said teenage boys, depends on what you mean by use. And finally, the Ritz Paris recently found a guest's missing $800,000 ring in the bag of a vacuum cleaner, which is also how Motel 6 recently found a guest's missing kid. That is way too young a kid. That joke does not work on that kid. 8. Like, that kid's never okay again. Yeah, they found him, but that kid's scarred for life. Well, I got bad news. That was our last one. We got a great show for you tonight. She is one of the all-time SNL greats and is returning this Saturday to host for the very first time. Kate McKinnon is back, everybody. He is a 10-time NBA All-Star. Paired with a brilliant comedian and friend of ours, their show 7 p.m. in Brooklyn is out Thursdays. Carmelo and Anthony and the Kid Mero are going to be joining us, everybody. And he is a comedian whose special Leo Reich, Literally Who Cares, is out on HBO and Max this weekend. Leo Reich will be performing some very funny stand-up for us. It's very exciting. We've got a new episode Family Trips. That's a podcast I do with my brother. You can check it out. We talk to guests about their family trips. Phil Kogan, he was our host this week, the host of The Amazing Race. Nobody we've ever had on our podcast has traveled more than him. Check it out. It's been a lot of fun to do. Moving on, guys. We here at Late Night don't always have enough time to cover all of the recent news. So here with a recap is one of our writers, Amber Ruffin, in a segment we call Amber Says What?
Crazy. Okay, first of all, I heard that Amy Robach and TJ Holmes from Good Morning America were having an affair, and I was like, what? Then I read that they got kicked off the show, and I was like, what? Then I heard that their exes are dating each other, and I was like, what is Good Morning America doing? Let all four of them host together and give us the chaos we deserve. Make that show last 24 hours long. Bring in a couples counselor and let the Emmys roll in, baby! Then I saw that Beyonce went to the opening of Taylor Swift's movie, and I was like, what? Why? Taylor is no Beyonce. Then I saw that Taylor went to Beyonce's movie, and I was like, what? Then I read that they went to each other's openings because people are always pitting them against each other, and they're sick of it. So I was like, what? I've been doing that. And then I vowed to stop. So then I read Taylor Swift was named Times Person of the Year, and I was like, what? A lovely choice. Then I saw the Rockefeller Center Christmas tree arrived, and I was like, what? Oh, geez, beautiful, loves attention, and is always at 30 Rock? Who are you, me? Then I read everybody was furious because Chris Wallace told Adam Driver he was ugly in an interview. And I was like, what? So turns out Chris Wallace was like, you don't look like the typical movie star, and would your career be better if you were better looking? And I was like, this is what happens when you let older white men talk to young people. Look, watch this. Hey, Seth, what did you say when you met my niece?
Oh, do you like Matchbox 20?
See, a bunch of mess. What do you mean? What does that even mean? Then I saw George Santos joined Cameo, and I was like, what? My favorite messy diva, George Santos, is on Cameo? What's a perfect Christmas gift? So I bought us all a little Cameo from him.
Hey, it's me. George Santos, don't be giving me any money. If you do, I'll probably just use it to steal another baby. Then, that's on you. This is definitely me, George Santos. George Santos plays video games, right?
Then I heard Brenda Lee recently celebrated that her song Rockin' Around the Christmas Tree made it to the top of the Billboard 100 for the first time since 1958. And I was like, what? Then I found out she was only 13 when she recorded it. And I was like, what does a 13-year-old know about rocking around the Christmas tree? Girl, you better have a seat. You're not old enough to be rocking around the nothing. It's your little fast tail. Then, during a town hall, Trump was asked if he got elected, was he gonna be a dictator? And Trump replied, only on day one. And I was like, what? The correct answer was no. Unless you're asking me that question, then the answer is yes. The citizens of Ruffinland are required to give me little kisses, fear and applaud me, or else. You would love to live there. You would never leave. Then I heard that it's Seth's birthday soon, and I was like, what? Then I heard he was turning 50, and I was like, what? Because I assume his hearing is starting to go. Seth, if you can hear me, say Amber's the most beautiful and talented writer I ever met, and we should trade salaries.
I'm not saying that.
He can't hear. Then I read that FSU was left out of the college football playoffs, even though they were undefeated. And I was like, what? This really affects me because I think those players at, I want to say, Florida State University?
Yeah, that's right.
Worked really hard to win, like, somewhere between 10 and 15 games.
Yeah, right again.
Yes, and they should be commended for that. So you gotta blame the head of football Dan Marino?
No. What?
Shut up. I did my best. Then the White House delayed its ban on menthol cigarettes over concerns that it will hurt Biden's popularity with black voters. And I was like, what? The nerve. How dare you be so loud and so right? Then the Oxford Dictionary named the slang word riz as the word of the year. It means having style, charm, or attractiveness. Seth, you got any riz?
Shoot, this Riz God is slanging these interviews on the daily.
Well, dang! Maybe Seth does have Riz.
I mean, not as much Riz as Matchbox 20, but...
Never mind. Guys, this has been Amber Says What.